do this or what?
Yeah.
Oh.
One of us is gonna have to change.
Come on.
It's gonna be you.
All right. Well, it's about time.
Welcome to Hot Takes. My name's Robbie.
I'm Corey.
And today we're going to be talking about the new SpongeBob movie.
Sponge on the Run.
That's right. But with a little bit of a twist.
All right. Today we have the brand new hot sauce from Bravado Spice Company's Ancho Masala.
Say that three times fast.
Yeah. No.
No.
This is... They say on their Instagram that this is their hottest sauce to date. And you've had some hot ones from these guys.
Yes.
We did the black garlic Carolina Reaper one.
Mm-hmm.
That was pretty hot.
That was. So, I'm a little scared.
We'll see what we're in for.
Yeah.
We're going to do things a little bit differently. This is not coming out.
Nope.
Hang on.
All right. All right, cool.
Well, I wasn't expecting that.
I was.
We'll be back after a short intermission.
A few moments later.
Take two.
So anyway, Sponge on the Run.
Sponge on the Run.
Got this hot sauce.
It's hot. It's got on my nose. Don't ask me what the thought process was for that.
It's okay.
It's just...
I'll leave it be.
It's done and over with. So since this is a brand new sauce, I haven't tried this before. We know it's going to be hot. Let's go ahead and taste it first.
Mm-hmm.
Just give our impressions.
Yes.
We got the Bugles from last week making a return. I wouldn't go crazy on this.
Oh, week. I'm not. No. I'm scared. So, cheers. Ow. It's gonna be like the bomb where, yep, of course. Where it's instantly just like, bomb.
Yeah.
I literally feel like a mini flame just like bursted in my mouth. Just like, I mean, it tastes better than the bomb.
It does.
Way better.
It doesn't
than the
have
bomb.
That smoky,
awful, diesel.
Yeah.
Like,
battery acid taste.
Mm-hmm. 7-Eleven, undistilled.
You soaked a bunch of 7-Eleven hot dogs and some Franks.
Yeah.
You get the bomb.
Exactly. This still hurts.
Still picking hot sauce off my face here.
God. I don't like this one.
Yeah, this one's hot.
Yeah.
This one is pretty hot.
The other one's burned my body. This one just like feels like I have a torch on my tongue.
So, are we ready for questions?
Yeah, we determined that it's hot.
It's hot. It's not playing around.
Nope. I'm not playing around with this either. Alexis, you know what to do.
Ask away.
Who are some of the characters in this movie?
There's the obvious crew. You got SpongeBob, Patrick, Squidward, Mr. Krabs, Plankton, you know, the usuals. But then you got King Poseidon.
King Poseidon, not King Neptune.
No.
Do we ever find out what happened to King Neptune?
No, it's not really explained.
He's just not there anymore.
No, but this whole movie feels like it's not supposed to be canon to previous things.
I hope not.
Yeah.
If you don't know anything about us, we have a very deep relationship with SpongeBob.
Very.
He goes down to the childhood.
Under the sea.
Under the sea. In a pineapple.
In Goo Lagoon.
Exactly. So, this movie means a little bit more to us.
Yeah.
Than something like Raya and the Last Dragon.
Or Tom and Jerry.
Or Tom and Jerry. This is SpongeBob we're talking here.
This is our childhood.
This is it.
And we got the Chancellor, who's played by Reggie Watts.
Mm-hmm. He's fun. There's the robot, played by Awkwafina.
That's right.
From Raya and the Last Dragon.
Unrecognizable.
No, not really.
Mm-hmm.
Otto.
Otto.
Was it supposed to be a male, female? Mr. Krabs called it a he.
Yeah.
Everyone else called it a they or an it. It's voiced by a woman.
Progressive.
It's progressive, you know?
Are you Flo?
Yes.
Is this the thing you gave my husband?
Well, that came out of nowhere.
We had Tiffany Haddock.
Because she's a hack.
Yeah, I don't really care for her much.
I don't care. She's fine, I guess. But she only liked her in anything.
She has one scene.
Yeah.
She's just a little bit player towards the end of the movie.
Mm-hmm. And you got Johnny Silverhand, a.k.a. John Wick, a.k.a. Keanu Reeves.
Yeah. He's a tumbleweed.
Yeah.
Named Sage. It's just his head.
Just his head, just bobbing around.
I'd be interested in seeing the filming process behind that.
Yeah.
Because I'm pretty sure they just wrapped his head in some tumbleweed material.
You think so?
I think so. And just threw, like, green screen footage underneath it.
That would be great. But how would they get, like, the fact that whenever he rolls, he tilts his head, is, like, gonna goes off?
I don't know. I think they just filmed him, like, tilting, and then they just leave it at that and just roll it. I think that's all it is.
Yeah.
I don't know, but it would be interesting to see.
Mm-hmm. He was surprisingly one of my favorite parts in the movie.
No, he was good. Mm-hmm. He was in there for longer than I thought he would.
Yeah.
Danny Trejo was in it.
Yep, El Diablo.
El Diablo. That's such a Danny Trejo character to play.
I know. Yeah. I was hoping they make a reference to Machete, but that's too adult.
No, yeah. You can't go that far in SpongeBob. Snoop Dogg was there.
Yep.
He did a little rap.
He had probably the best song in the movie.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah.
One of two songs that were in the movie.
Yeah. I thought there was like... No, there's like three, because there's one where when Gary goes missing. Or was that just a pop song?
It might have just been a pop song.
I think, yeah.
I don't know. I know they sang two songs in the movie.
Yeah.
The characters did. Mm-hmm. That one was good. The one at the end, not good.
Not at all.
Not good. We'll get into that later, but...
Exactly.
Yeah. You
know. Next question.
Spicy.
Spicy.
What did you think about the technical aspects of this movie, specifically focusing on the CGI and the animation?
Well, I liked a majority mm-hmm. of the animation. There was just certain scenes and like certain frames that looked a little off.
Yeah, no, I get that. It looked kind of like computerized stop motion.
Yeah, it did.
At a lot of points.
Kind of like the Peanuts movie.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't see it, but from the trailers, it had that similar look to it.
I did see it.
Yeah.
I don't remember too much about it, but mm-hmm. I remember it not being bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, the animation, it looks good.
It does.
It doesn't look like classic SpongeBob.
Of course not.
But that's not what they're going for.
No.
And it blended pretty well with live action.
Yeah.
Again, we're looking at you, Tom and Jerry. Why does this keep coming up?
I know.
It's haunting us forever.
Mm-hmm.
The effects on Danny Trejo, when he, like, burns alive?
Uh-huh.
He was pretty realistic.
Yeah, it was kind of graphic.
A little bit. It's a little freaky
mm-hmm.
for a kid's movie. Other than that, it's just, you know, it's very kind of jarring to see SpongeBob's world in a three-dimensional space.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you can see the sandy texture of the bottom of his house.
Yeah.
Or just how wet everything is.
Yeah, like
despite the fact that they're underwater, you know, he's dumping out the can of snail food. It's just glistening.
Yeah.
Where you got King Poseidon smearing snails all over his face. And it's just obscene. It's like, yeah. It looks really good.
It does.
The music was fine.
Yeah.
I mean, there's a lot of pop songs.
Yeah, but they weren't terribly placed.
They weren't. No. It kind of reminded me of the first SpongeBob movie, mm-hmm. where it had a few here and there.
Yeah, yeah.
And it works for them. It almost makes it look kind of like a colorful music video.
Mm-hmm.
And I like it. It's fine.
Me too. I didn't find the score to be amazing. It was fine. But considering the fact that it was scored by
Hans Zimmer.
Yeah.
Of all people.
Why?
I don't know. But he did the score.
It was fine.
But I didn't notice anything, any of his signature, you know, mm-hmm. kind of loud, Inception-y mm-hmm. inspired noises.
Nothing really popped out.
No. It was very... simple.
Yeah, but it was fine.
It was fine.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess we could talk about the voice actors.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, it's the whole original cast, except for the flashback scenes.
Yeah, they used kids' voices. Mm-hmm.
They used child actors for the child versions of the characters when mm-hmm. they flash back to Camp Coral.
Yeah.
And I wasn't a fan of that,
personally. No, that whole sequence, without spoiling anything, where they do flashbacks to Camp Coral. Mm-hmm. Probably the worst part of the film. It's not terrible.
Yeah, it's not terrible.
It just, that scene in general just kind of drags, and it's just like, of course I'm going to show this, this, and this. It's going to take 15 minutes.
It felt like they were selling the new TV show.
100%.
That's exactly what it felt like. Yeah. And during the new, or in the new TV show, they use the original voice cast, and they just, you know, make a more high-pitched voice, or whatever. And it sounds fine.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not, like, a fan of that show, but... It sounds good. It sounds like SpongeBob voices.
Exactly. Whereas this one, it just sounds like Jacob Tremblay.
Yeah.
Is the voice of all four of the kids, because they all sound very similar.
They do, yeah. I mean, except for Sandy, I guess. But...
Yeah, but...
I don't know, it just... We'll talk about that more with our least favorite things.
Yeah.
So we'll come back to that.
We'll come back to it.
Just looking at a couple insane people listening to Hot Sauce.
Put it in your ear.
No.
I will not put it in my ear.
Absolutely.
How dare you? Next question.
The nerve.
What were your favorite things about this movie?
The SpongeBobiness.
Yeah.
Like I said, we're both huge fans of SpongeBob. Pretty much anything, you know, season 1 to 4 and the first movie.
Gold. Classic.
Let me tell you this. When you ask me any trivia question involving the first couple episodes or seasons of SpongeBob or the movie, I will know it.
Me too.
It's anything. Try me. Challenge me. I will know. So, SpongeBob is very important.
This is a challenge statement for the comment section.
Right now, how many pickles were under Bubble Bass's tongue?
4.
Was he right? But yeah, my favorite things is just how very SpongeBob it is. It's very reminiscent of the good portions of what we grew up with SpongeBob. Granted, nowadays the character is very different than what it used to be.
Yeah.
But that's not a bad thing. It's for a new audience. They're doing a new thing. Mm-hmm. But for what it is currently, I still thought they did a good job. Like, because it's still very wacky, random, you know, all over the place.
No, yeah. I think their characterizations are very reminiscent of how they started.
Yeah.
Maybe they're a little off, but overall, it's pretty similar.
Yeah. Which is a good thing.
It is a good thing. He doesn't have socks.
What?
There's no socks on that SpongeBob. Get out of here, you faker.
Faker! Cheers.
Next question. I got a lot on this one.
Oh my god. Why?
It's what I do.
What were your least favorite things about this movie?
The sauce.
Sauce is rough. Alright.
So my least favorite thing, personally, would have to be that scene that we mentioned that kind of goes into the whole Camp Coral stuff, where it genuinely just feels like a 15-minute ad placement for the TV show.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like it really adds to much of anything.
I guess we could probably get into some light spoiler talk here.
Yeah, it's SpongeBob.
I mean, just watch the movie if you like SpongeBob.
Get Paramount Plus for 30 days for free. Also, watch The Console Wars.
I don't know what that is.
Watch it. It's the only other thing worth watching on Paramount Plus, okay?
There you go. Anyways. All right, but if you don't want to see spoilers, just go ahead and skip to this point.
Yeah.
And we'll just be talking about it regularly. So the scene that you're talking about is at the end. They're having a trial to execute Patrick and SpongeBob. There's no play on words there.
No.
It's just like, we're going to kill them.
Literally.
It's kind of aggressive. But Plankton, Sandy, Mr. Krabs, and Squidward all show up, and they all each have a story of how they first met SpongeBob, and it's all at Camp Coral.
All.
Every single one of them. Forget, you know, him meeting Sandy, fighting the clam, tea at the tea dome, or tree dome.
Tree dome.
Him knowing Patrick since they were like
infants.
Little eggs floating around at one point. Meeting Mr. Krabs at the Krusty Krab when he gets the job.
Yeah.
Being Squidward's neighbor. Forget all that. Mm-mm. They met at camp.
Camp Coral.
Camp Coral. And all this is because they're trying to get Gary away from King Poseidon.
And that could have been cut down to like 3 minutes where one person gives one speech.
They really could.
They all come together like, we love SpongeBob, and then they do the number and they leave.
Yeah.
They didn't need all that.
Could have been him.
But Camp Coral.
Yeah, I gotta push that Camp Coral.
Tune in at whatever time.
Tune into Camp Coral on Paramount Plus.
Yeah.
I don't know. I saw like the first 10 minutes of the
episode. 10 episodes?
No.
Just watch the whole season.
No. I saw like the first 10 minutes of the first episode.
Yeah.
Eh.
Sounds about right.
That's about it. That's all I have to say.
Okay.
Eh. Eh. Not my thing. But it's not terrible.
But that'd have to be the only thing I didn't really care for about the movie.
Yeah.
I thought everything else was solidly paced.
I was having a good time. I was laughing.
It was fun. It's goofy. It's kind of like a lucid dream. A
little bit.
Yeah. Which is kind of similar to the last movie. Not the first one, but Sponge Out of Water.
Yeah, I don't remember that one too much.
I particularly just remember a scene where they're like laughing like, ah, and they're just like going through this weird like acid trip.
I don't remember it. I know I've seen this movie, but I do not remember it.
Interesting.
At all. I don't know why. I've only seen it once though.
I've seen it like 3 times.
You have like cousins though, right? Oh.
No.
Well, there you go. But yeah, that's really my only complaint. And it's just, the look of it isn't bad, it's just kind of jarring at times.
Yeah.
And that's
But it could have been a lot worse.
Yeah.
So I'm fine with it.
I'm fine with it. Mm-hmm. It's really just that one scene.
Yeah.
Kind of brings the whole thing down for me.
It doesn't ruin it for me, but it is absolutely the worst part of the film.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
This movie definitely was not trying to cater to the smaller audience.
Mm-mm.
No. But they know who's going to actually pay to go watch a SpongeBob movie.
It's us. Yeah.
Stupid kids. Get out of here.
No, no one likes you. Ugh. Get your boogers out of here. You nasty.
Ugh. Gross.
Alright. How'd you feel about the thank you Steven Hillenburg thing?
That was sweet. Granted, like, it seems like, oh, well, that happened like a few years ago, but this movie was finished.
Mm-hmm.
Everything was done literally well over a year ago.
Yeah.
It just took forever to get to
where I like that. Appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was pretty sad when he died.
I was too.
It's my childhood.
Literally.
What were your general and overall thoughts about this movie?
Overall, I really enjoyed this film. It was a very good execution of a SpongeBob film, considering how everything has changed within the newer seasons and not having Steven Hillenburg anymore. I really enjoyed it.
I didn't even get any sauce, and I was just so taken aback by you just globbing that right off Patrick's head there. Sorry, I'm gonna... When I say go big or go home...
So I guess, Corey, what are your overall thoughts? Yeah.
Yeah, it was good.
Yeah.
It was a solid hour and a half of SpongeBob.
It was.
Mm-hmm. I don't think it ruined its legacy or anything like I'm seeing some people talk about.
Yeah, it's not that terrible.
It's not.
It's fine.
It's a pretty fun movie, actually.
Yeah, just keep your standards in check. This isn't the original, you know, first 5 seasons of SpongeBob. Four seasons, whatever. This is modern SpongeBob, but it's done the best I think it could have been.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I don't think they could have... Sure, they could have added things, taken things away, but I don't think they could have done any better.
No.
It is what it is, and I think Steven Hillenburg would have appreciated it.
He would have. So, Corey, what would you rate this film?
I would...
Don't get too emotional, man.
No.
It's just a film.
I know. It's fine. I need a moment, you know? It's just a lot to take in.
It is.
All right. So I would rate SpongeBob, Sponge on the Run, 3.5 manly fire-fueled tears out of 5. It's a lot.
Yeah, I think I'm going to go the same as you. I'm going to rate this 3.5 dummy thick Patrick's out of 5.
Ugh. So Robbie, how'd you feel about the ancho masala scorpion reaper sauce?
Easily the hottest sauce we've done.
For sure.
Easily the hottest sauce of theirs. They're not lying with that.
No, they're definitely not.
It's very reminiscent of the bomb in the sense that it's immediate.
It is very immediate.
It doesn't take a second.
No.
It just doesn't. Boom. It
punches you right in the face.
Yeah.
I can feel it in my chest.
Go check it out, though.
Yeah, check it out. We'll leave a link in the description. I know it's very hard to taste the flavors of it when you're not used to high levels of heat.
Yeah.
But it's got a good flavor to it.
And it's tolerable. If you've done the bomb and you can handle that, you can handle this. You're not going to lose your mind over it.
A couple drops in your food, you'll be fine.
Yeah. All right, so be sure to like, comment, subscribe to... You're not Corey.
What are you talking about?
What? Anyways, like I said, thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe. Mm-hmm. Let us know what type of hot sauces you want us to keep trying. What kind of movies we should be reviewing.
Next week, we're probably going to do the new Zack Snyder cut of Justice League.
Pray for us.
That is 4 hours of Zack Snyder Justice League. So,
ugh. God.
Yeah, I'm not looking forward to that.
At all.
Stick around for our cooldown. We're going to be talking about the first SpongeBob movie.
The best SpongeBob movie.
The SpongeBob movie.
Oh, I'm a goofy goober, yeah. You're a goofy goober, yeah.